वंदे श्री रमणर्षेः आचार्यस्य पदाब्जम् यो मे अदर्शयदीशं भान्तं ध्वान्तं अतीत्य ओंकारवदनं वंद्यं कवीनां आदिमं कविं वंदे गणपतिं देवं नरवेशधरं गुरुं वेदैर्बोधवती गिरां विलसितैः सम्मोदमुद्रावती धीरैर्भारतसूरिभिर्बलवती पूर्वैः प्रतिष्ठावती मंत्रैः मित्रवती महर्षिचरणैः आचार्यलक्ष्मीवती काव्यैः कंठवती धिया धनवती कस्मैश्चिदस्मै नमः।
ओम नमो भगवते श्री रमणाय। काव्यकंठ गणपति मुनि दैट इज नायनास उमा सहस्रम वासिष्ठ काव्यकंठ गणपति मुनि belongs to the rare race of intellectual and spiritual giants. Nearly a year before his birth, his mother Narsamamba had been to the famous Surya temple at Arasavalli near Srikakulam in Andhra Pradesh to offer her prayers and worship. She stayed overnight in the temple after the traditional worship of the Lord. In the next early morning, she had a dream in which a beautiful woman with a golden divine radiance emerged from the corridors of the temple, approached her with a smiling face and a shining pot of fire, and giving it in her hands, vanished. To her utter astonishment, the moment the fire pitcher came into contact with Narsamamba, it entered her womb and assumed the form of a child. She believed that her child was a divine gift of God Agni. While she was waiting to deliver the child, her husband Narasimha Shastri had gone to Varanasi and was performing tapas in the Dundi Ganapati temple near Vishveshwara Ghat. He had the vision of a little child emanating from the deity Ganapati and coming near him. After these wonderful experiences by both, a child was born on 17th November 1878. The father appropriately named him Ganapati. Ganapati was educated entirely at home. His father, like his ancestors, was an expert and well-versed in Mantra Shastra, Astrology and Ayurveda. With this traditional family background, proficiency in these subjects came naturally to Ganapati. He finished studying the classical Sanskrit poems and then devoted himself to the study of grammar and poetics. At the same time, he delved deep into the writings of Vyasa and Valmiki Maharishis. Like the ancient rishis, Ganapati wanted to experience immense strength and power by the practice of tapasya through mantra japa and meditation. When Ganapati was doing tapasya in Kashi, he came to know that an assembly of scholars, Harisabha, would be held in the famous city of Navadvipa in Bengal. On the advice of his friends, he got a letter of introduction and went to Navadvipa. There he excelled in all the difficult tests that he was put to with an effortless ease that stunned his examiners, who unanimously confirmed the title Kavyakantha, one who has poetry in his throat, voice of poetry, on him forthwith. He was only 22 years old then. Ganapati Muni, in his 25th year, went to Kanchipuram and then to Arunachalam, that is Thiruvannamalai, to perform tapas. He visited twice Sri Brahmana Swami, who was later named as Bhagavan Sri Ramana Maharshi by the Ganapati Muni himself. On 18th November 1907, Ganapati Muni approached Bhagavan Ramana Maharshi, who was then staying in the Virupaksha cave, and prostrating himself at his feet, said in a trembling voice, "All that has to be read, I have read. Even Vedanta Shastra, I have fully understood. I have performed japa and puja to my heart's content. Yet, I have not up to this time understood what tapas is. Hence, have I sought refuge at thy feet. Pray, enlighten me about the nature of tapas." For quite some time, the Brahmana Swami gazed silently at Kavyakanta and then spoke gently. "If one watches where his notion of I springs, the mind will be absorbed into that. That is tapas. If a mantra is repeated, the attention is directed to the source where the mantra sound is produced. The mind will be absorbed in that. That is tapas." The scholar poet was filled with joy to have found his guru and announced the Upadesham as Maharishi's original, and that the Brahmana Swami was indeed a Maharishi and should be called so thereafter as Bhagavan Sri Ramana Maharishi. Following this momentous meeting, Ganapati Muni composed his great devotional poem Uma Sahasram, a 1,000 verses in praise of Uma, the Divine Mother, as a part of his tapas and also as a gratitude to the great goddess for having given him the Maharishi as his guru. This Uma Sahasram is the magnum opus of Sri Kavyakanta Ganapati Muni. After this momentous meeting with the Maharishi, the Muni wanted to continue his tapas. At the suggestion of Bhagwan, he repaired to the mango tree cave on the Arunachala hill. Here he decided to compose the verses in praise of the goddess Uma, and the Maharishi gave his tacit approval and blessings. The Muni took a vow that he would complete the 1,000 verses in 20 days and started the composition on 26th November 1907. On the last day, that is 15th December 1907, he had yet to compose more than 200 verses. So he engaged 5 scribes and dictated all the required verses in the night. The Maharishi sat by his side with his eyes closed. It was midnight and all the verses of the Uma Sahasram were completed. The Maharishi then opened his eyes and asked, "Have you written down all that was said?" The Muni replied, "With your abounding grace, I have completed the task." Realizing that he owed to the Maharishi, the sudden flurry of inspiration that seized him that day, enabling him to complete his immortal poem on Uma. As a result, each verse of Uma Sahasram has the potency of a mantra. A devoted recital or even the mere reading of it can bestow all happiness on the devout aspirant. The poet then revised this sacred text 7 times, but left the last day composition of more than 200 verses untouched, as they are the verses direct from Bhagavan Sri Ramana Maharishi. The text is divided into 40 cantos, each having 25 verses. In all, the poet has used 29 different meters in this work. The first verse of each canto is a benedictory verse extolling the smile of the goddess Uma. The last verse in each canto mentions the name of the meter employed in the canto. The process of creation, the supreme form of the empress of all, the manifestation of the Vedic and the Tantric deities, the means to win their grace, yogic experiences resulting from their upasana, the truth of the 10 great vidyas, Dasamaha Vidya, the way of their adoration, the relevant sadhanas in the Upanishads, such are the profound truths presented by the seer poet in sublime poetry, drawing from the deep reservoir of his personal spiritual experiences. Uma Sahasram is a living synthesis of the Vedas, the Upanishads, and the tantra built out of his lifelong realization in yoga. Each verse opens the door to spiritual experience.
Vyoma sharira stri rupacha arya vrittam.
अखिल जगन् मातु मा तमसा तापी न चाकुलानस्मान् अनुगृह्णात्मनुकम्पा सुधार्द्रया हसित चन्द्रिकया
निखिलेषु प्रवहन्तीं निरुपाधि विमर्शयोग दृश्योर्मिम् अजराम जाममेयां कामपि वन्दे महाशक्तिम्
सातत्वतः समन्तात् सत्यस्य विभोस्तथा तपःशक्तिः लीला महिला वपुषा हैमवती तनुषु कुण्डलिनी
परमः पुरुषो नाभिर्लोकानां सत्य उच्यते लोकः परितस्ततः सरन्ति सूक्ष्माशक्तिस्तपो लोकः
अन्तर्गूढार्थानां पुरुषाग्नेर्धूमकल्प उद्गारः ज्वालः परितः प्रान्तेष्व भवज्जनो लोकः
अतिसूक्ष्मधूमकल्पं लोकं तदमाख्ययान्ययानाकम् एतं ततोऽपि सूक्ष्मा व्याप्तान्तरतः पराशक्तिः
कल्पा शुद्ध ज्वालोपमा चया शक्तिः तां दिवमाहुः केचन परमं व्योमा परे प्राहुः
उद्गीर्ण धूमकल्पो यूयमपारो महाञ्जनो लोकः व्योमान्तरिक्ष गगन प्रभृतिभिः अभिधाभिराहुस्तम्
प्रान्तेषु कोऽपि शक्तेः पृथगात्मा वियदुबाधि सङ्गेन परमात्मनो विभक्तः स्वयमभिमन्ता विनिष्पीदे
दक्षः परोक्षमुदितः पन्था एष त्विषां जनो लोकः तद्गर्भे लब्धात्मा कथिता दाक्षायणी शक्तिः
सत्या प्रागपि शक्तेः प्रादुर्भावः सकीर्त्यति प्रथमः ईशाभिमानमय्याः पृथगभिमानित्वनिष्पत्त्या
आकाशस्य सुतैवं लक्षणया वस्तुतः प्रसूशक्तिः अदितेर्दक्षो दक्षात् अदितिरिति श्रुतिरबाधैवम्
जगता माता पितरौ सति सती भवौ केऽपि पण्डितः प्राहुः अदिति प्रजापति तौ अपरेषां भाषया विदुषा
दिव्यपुमाकृतिमीशे बिभ्रति लीलार्थमस्य रमणाय दिव्यवनिता कृतिं सामभारमाता च भुवनानाम्
भासुरहेमाभरणा बहुशोभां ईश्वर प्रमोदकलां मूर्तिं पावनकीर्तिं तां हैमवती उमामाहुः
तस्य प्रथमः साक्षी भुवनचुषां नयनशालिनां मध्ये वपुषः किलादिसुदृशो निरुपमपुण्यो निलिम्पपतिः
पल्लवमृदुवेदिगत ज्वलनपवित्रं महार्घमणिकान्तम् नवचन्द्रखण्डसौम्यं शिवसुदृशः तत्स्मरामि वपुः
केचन गौरीं देवीं सीताद्रेर्देवतात्मनो जातां कथयन्ति स्त्रियमुत्तम लावण्या स्वादितो गण्याम्
सत्यैव भवतु सेयं कथा तथापि प्रभाषितां भक्तैः मादिसुदृशो जानीयात् कमपि तेजोंशम्
मन्यन्ते केऽपि घनं पर्वतमुक्तं निगूढया वाचा प्रादुर्भवति गभीर ध्वनिरविषह्या यतः शक्तिः
गोलेभ्यो यद्वितरति निजरजश्चयादन्नम् निशाय कीर्त्यते सा संसारे दक्षयागकथा
व्याप्तापि अन्निगूढा बहिरीक्षकबुद्ध्यपेक्षया नष्टा शक्तिर्यागे तस्मिन् अवसानं तदुदितं सत्याः
पर्वतनाम्नो वैदिकभाषायां यदियम् अतिबलाशक्तिः घनतो भवति व्यक्ता तदभिहितं पार्वतीजननम्
तेजोंशतः शिवा विह हिमाचले अनुग्रहाय भूमिजुषा दत्तो यत्सान्निध्यं लीलाचारित्रं मन्यदिदम्
एतासाम् आर्याणां जानन्तशास्त्रसम्मतं भावम् जानीयुर्भव महिषीं भुवनानाम् अम्बिकां देवीं।